been a little over a month since that deadly gas explosion at Minnehaha Academy that killed two beloved staffers. And while it's unclear when the upper campus will be back to normal, a new normal for students begins tomorrow at a new location in a whole new city. Melissa Colorado spoke with the upper school principal and joins us now with more. Hi, Melissa.
Hi there, Kim. This building in Mendota Heights used to be the Brown Institute, a for-profit college that has now closed. And it's no wonder this was the ideal choice. There were already large classrooms, a library, a fitness center, and lots of parking. The problem, it didn't feel like a high school. Until now, contractors and volunteers teamed up to transform this building in just 2 weeks. 900 pieces of furniture were ordered in. Decals were put on the walls with inspiring messages like "Together we rise." However, students will have to adjust to some changes. There is no gym and there is no kitchen, meaning lunch will be catered. Instead of an auditorium, staffers created an open space called the chapel, where there will be rows of chairs and big screen monitors. That's where the school is holding a building dedication service tonight at 7 p.m.
Instead of settling for a building as a temporary place to have school, this is a building they're going to have pride in. I mean, when you walk around in there and you see the decals on the walls and the sayings and the history of our school that's been incorporated into the design, the colors, the furniture.
And there's a part of the new building that has key offices like the registrar, counseling, attendance, and the principal's office. That area will be renamed the Ruth Berg and John Carlson Service Center in memory of the two longtime staffers who died in the gas explosion last month. Kim?
Thanks, Melissa.